हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश फॉर 10 क्लासेस एक्सरसाइज 2। गेट रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन। स्टार्ट। द नेशनल एजेंडा हैज़ स्टेटेड इन क्लियर एंड यूनाम्बिगुअस टर्म्स दैट माय गवर्नमेंट शैल स्ट्राइव टू डेवलप ए नेशनल कंसेंसस ऑन ऑल मेजर इश्यूज कन्फ्रंटिंग द नेशन। स्टॉप। The problems facing the Indian economy are too many, too complex, and far too important to be subjected to a partisan approach. Stop. We simply cannot afford to play politics with the nation's economy anymore. Stop. This indeed will be the real test of patriotism on the economic front. Stop. This point demands candid and even self-critical elaboration. Stop. The first phase of economic liberalization was launched in 1991. Stop. Some of the reforms brought about positive changes. Stop. Unfortunately, the measures taken to free the economy were not matched by checks and balances. Stop. And we have paid a price for those lapses. Stop. Also, the liberalization process suffered from inadequate attention to the eradication of unemployment and to many critical issues in the social sector such as healthcare, education and housing. Stop. Importantly, it failed to give a momentum to infrastructure development, which is now choking growth. Stop. In our view, the reasons lie in the failure of the government to effectively address the core concerns of the Indian industry. Stop. They lie in the failure of the Indian industry to appreciate the core concerns of the government. Stop. They also lie in the failure of both the government and the industry to convince the common man that he too has a stake, a vital stake in the reforms process. Stop. That is why during the election campaign I repeatedly stressed that India urgently needs to reform the reforms process. Stop. To explain what we mean by this, let me first enumerate what I think are the three main complaints of the industry against the government. The three main complaints of the government against the industry, and also the three main complaints of the common man against both the government and the industry. Stop. The three chief complaints of the industry against the government are: one, industry thinks the government is the root cause of avoidable delays owing to excessive controls. Stop. Even after 7 years of reforms, a typical industrialist is forced to spend considerable time in management of the government than in management of his own business. Stop. Two, industry complains that the government takes too much but provides too little, and that too haphazardly. Stop. Three, the government is in all those areas of business in which it had no business to be there in the first place. Stop. Now let us look at the three chief complaints of the government against the industry. Stop. One, government feels that the industry does not share its social objectives. Stop. Two, the industry wants the government to govern well. Stop.